Welcome back. Over the next few videos, we're going to set up our spawn volume. Up until now, we've just been dragging in pickups to test, like this battery here and the pickup over there. And that's great for testing, but for gameplay, we want these pickups to fall from the sky at regular intervals. It'll take a couple videos to set this up entirely, but I'll make sure we get to a place where we can compile at the end of each one, and at the end, we're going to have a really awesome functional spawn volume. Really quick, just to go over what our spawn volume will need in it, we will have a spawn volume that will tell us where to, or that will have functionality to determine where to spawn, what to spawn, and when to spawn. So the first video is going to go over setting up where to spawn, the next video is going to show over setting up what to spawn, and then finally we'll use timers to tell the spawn volume when to spawn. And while I'm in here in the level editor, I'm just going to delete the two pickups that we dragged in there so that when we're testing our spawn volume later, we don't have to worry about those hanging around. So we're going to create another code class. We can come back here to the content browser and add a new C++ class. Again, going back to almost like flowchart of what kind of class to inherit from, our spawn volume is just going to be something that's placed in the level. That doesn't really need too much more than that, so we can base it on actor again. Go ahead and click next, and we're going to call this spawn volume. And go ahead and create the class, which is going to recompile the code, reload the module, and then we'll get started adding our where to spawn functionality. Okay, so our module recompiled and our spawn volume header and source file have opened up in Visual Studio. Now actually the where to spawn code is going to look really similar to when we added a mesh component to our pickup in the first pickup video. Again, we're going to make a component. This time it's going to be a box component. And then again, make that private and have a function to access it publicly. So let's go ahead and make that private box component. So again, we're going to use that forward declaration class. It's going to be a uBox component pointer. And we're going to call that where to spawn. Again, this is going to get a lot of the same uProperty keywords that our other component did. So visible anywhere. Blueprint read only. It's going to be in the category of spawning, not the category of pickup like the mesh was. And then we'll put in that meta keyword as well, allow private access equals true. Now, we're not going to make a blueprint of the spawn volume during this series. We're just going to place it directly in the level and manipulate it there just to show a different workflow. But if it turns out you wanted to have different specialized spawn volumes, you could certainly make blueprints, and that's why we left this blueprint read-only keyword in there. Now back up here under public, we're going to, let's actually go comment this really quick before we walk away from it. If I could, there we go. And this is going to just be the box component to specify where pickups should be spawned. And now we can go up here under public, and we're going to use that force inline trick again. So force inline, uBox component, and I get a pointer. So class uBox component. Get where to spawn. And that's just a general naming convention of being like get and then the variable name. Although sometimes when you see you have booleans, you'll get is because that's just the same answer is active or not as active, making it more of a question. Const, and then return where to spawn. And I did want to clarify one thing is over here back in our pickup, we actually, speaking of bool is active, we didn't use force inline here. And that's because the uFunction macro is actually not compatible with making a function force inline. And so If we wanted to say, like I said, make this git mesh, the blueprint callable, you would have to not then have this function be force inline. So, sorry, back to the spawn volume header. We have set up our private components, our public accessor function, which we should make a note on really quick. Returns the where to spawn subobject. And again, this might be sounding a little bit familiar. We're now going to go to our constructor, which was automatically set up here, and create the uBox component component using the constructor. So where we're going to create the box component to represent the spawn volume. I say volume, it's really more of an area. It's going to be very sort of flat rectangle or rectangular prism within the world, but it's still a volume. And so where to spawn equals create default subobject. Again, I'm going to let autocomplete help me out there a little bit. U box component. Oops. And then again, label this here with the text macro. Just give it again where to spawn. So that's what the name it'll show up with in the editor as well. We'll also set the box component as the root component, just because that way if we add anything else, it will be centered around the box component, because that makes most sense with the gameplay logic. In here with the spawn volume constructor, if you remember in the pickup, we also turned off ticking every frame because we didn't end up using it and it will improve performance. And I happen to know that we're not going to use tick in the spawn volume either, so we can go ahead and make that be false. And honestly, if later on I wanted to come back here and add tick functionality, it's super easy just to set it to true, recompile, we're good to go. Now the last thing we're going to do is create a function to find a random point in our volume, right? Not just, hey, here's this place in the world where pickups can be spawned, but where within there are the pickups actually going to originate? So back to the header file, and we can actually make this function public. And I'll explain why in just a minute. So we're going to call this function get random points in volume. And it's not going to take any arguments because it's just in this volume. And it's going to return a vector, obviously that point within the volume. It's going to be, we're going to use a u function here, our u function macro, and make it blueprint pure, which if you remember from some of the previous videos means it doesn't have execution pins because it's not actually going to change anything about our spawn volume, anything about our spawning behavior. It's just going to return some random point for us. And again, we'll make this in the category spawning. And so it's going to basically find just a random point for us here and return it in the f vector. So let's set up the behavior for this function. We go over to our spawn volume source file, and let's see, where was it? Kind of behind or sort of under tick, so we'll put it in the same place here. And so it's f vector returns a vector for us, spawn volume. Get random points in the volume. And so from the spawn volume, all box components will have an origin and a box extent, and those are stored as vectors. So let's go ahead and get those. We'll call that spawn origin. And it's really just as easy as calling that or accessing where to spawn. And get the bounds origin. And if you notice here, we are able to just use access where to spawn directly rather than having to write out get where to spawn as a function call. And that's because we are within the spawn volume class itself. If we were in, say, the game mode, we would have to call or use get where to spawn instead. Just going to use the same structure to get this spawn extent. And so again, where to spawn and get bounds box extent. And during your project, your game creation, you'll probably come across some of the Kismet libraries, which are a bunch of functions that maybe return your player controller, give all sorts of helpful functionality, and they're accessible not just from blueprints, which, you know, Kismet library, but they're also accessible from code, and it's perfectly fine to use them rather than have to write your own version, because this way they'll just be available in all of your projects. To use them, just go here to the top of spawn volume and include kismet/kismet math library, because Kismet math library has a function in it called get random point in bounding box, and it takes an origin and a box extent as variables. So it really is going to make this way smoother than having to calculate a random x, y, and z ourselves. So right here, we're just going to return uKismetMathLibrary, autocomplete. And there's this random point in bounding box, which if you look right here, returns a vector, takes the origin and the box extent. And it's in that KismetMathLibrary.h if you want to go check it out. So we'll just supply the spawn origin and the spawn extent that we pulled out previously. And honestly, if you wanted to put both, you know, all in one long line, you could. I just prefer this for a little bit of clarity in this video series. So at this point, let's do a test compile. And I know previously we were going over to the editor to compile, but let me just show you how to do it here in Visual Studio 2. Right-click on Battery Collector and build. And that's going to compile. You'll be able to see the log go by the same way that you get the log in the editor. And you can see it's again compiling game modules for hot reload. But this will just be easier since we're not ready to go back to the editor yet and make any changes. So when this is done compiling, we'll then go set up where to what to spawn. Thanks.